Chances are, if you're measuring height, then you're using boring old centimeters, which, given the range of human heights, doesn't contain many fun numbers. But if you use freedom units, that is, feet and inches, then we have the obvious 6'9" and we have 5'8", which, converting foot to inches, yields 4'20". Subtracting 5'8" from 6'9" gives us 11 in base 12, or 13, or a prime number. Now, prime usually refers to the best or peak quality of something, meaning at most 6'9 would equal prime because that's the best possible value it can have. And we note that 5'8 can't be negative because we don't typically measure skills in negative numbers. If you're bad, you just have zero skill, not negative. The only combination of values that satisfies the equality is 6'9 is equal to prime and 5'8 is worthless, or equal to zero. Which makes sense because guys under 6 foot are apparently not worth dating or some other bad joke. Okay, but this assumes that things can't exceed their prime. For instance, in any shonen ever, the main protagonist always pushes past their prime and reaches further heights. So maybe the same is true for these heights. If we represent 5'8 in base 11 and 6'9 in base 13, we'd get 62 and 63 respectively. If we conveniently ignore their bases and do everything in base 10, then 62 is considered semi-prime, it's the product of two prime numbers. And 63 is apparently square prime, although I could only find a reference this way in this specific Wikipedia article. Anyways, semi means half, so we can replace 5'8 with half prime, or 1/2 p. And of course, we'd do the same with square prime, which is prime squared. And from earlier, we know that this expression is equal to prime. So solving for prime, we'd see that prime equals 3/2. But this result doesn't make any sense. 3/2 quarters? Dollars? Yuan? We need units to determine what anything is really worth. So of course on this side we'd have a unit of prime, and the other side of the equation didn't specify, so we'll just call them units for now. Using proof by grammar, we can say the following sentence. A unit of prime is equal to 3/2 of a unit. The second unit, by convention, must refer to a unit of prime. Just like how if I say, that man is worth 1,000 others, the word others must refer to men. So if something is worth 1.5 times itself, we'd only have two possibilities. Either prime is infinitely valuable, which isn't the case because that would imply prime consists of infinitely many things or be impossibly rare to find, which it isn't. Which means prime would have to equal zero. It's worthless.